Okay. Mikhail Garasev.
Okay. So first of all, I would like to thank the organizers for the opportunity to give a talk here on this wonderful conference. I'll present the results of our work with colleagues from Institute of Applied Physics from Nizhny Novgorod, Evgeny Delishev and Vladimir Kocharovsky, and I will talk about the redistribution effects in the cyclotron resonance scattering. So why to study cyclotron lines at all at those times? This problem have been studied for decades, but in view of upcoming space missions like XARM, Athena, or Lynx, the detailed models of radiation transfer could be very useful to model the spectral features with high precision and to extract some physical data from that observations. Also, it is very useful if you want to study the structure of the outer layers of neutron stars' atmospheres, or want to study the radiation pressure effects in the atmospheres of neutron stars or accreting sources. And also, in the recent paper of Rothschild, these redistribution effects was used to build a model of the outburst in accreting X-ray binary. So to feed the data, they used some model which includes the redistribution of radiation in the lines. So the transfer of radiation happens in the atmosphere of neutron stars, which is about 10 centimeters in height if in physical units. And it characterizes by the wide range of temperatures and magnetic field strengths. In these atmospheres and in magnetospheres, scattering strongly dominates our absorption. And the opacity of magnetized plasma are very high near the frequencies, near the cyclotron frequencies. So the problem which I will talk about is that the resonance scattering in cyclotron lines is qualitatively different from the resonance scattering in atomic lines. So there are, in radiation transfer theory, there are several approximate methods to deal with frequency redistribution in resonant lines. As to say complete frequency redistribution, then people try to approximate the real redistribution with some functions, basically that tells you that photon forgot about its initial position after one scattering. The opposite case is coherent scattering, then the photon remains remembers its initial state after many scatterings, and the partial redistribution is something in between. It's the most interesting but most complex case, and I will talk about it in view of cyclotron lines. So here, the little sketch of basic view of cyclotron scattering. Here's the frequency and the propagation angle with respect to the magnetic field. You can divide basically the photons into two groups. The first group is the photons in the wing, which scatters almost coherently with a little frequency shift in each scattering. And the second group is the photons in the line, which travels along some inclined lines and scatters almost coherently. They do not preserve the frequency itself, but they preserve some a function of frequency and the angle with respect to the magnetic field. So this is kind of a quasi-coherent approximation. This holds exactly if you work in the non-relativistic approximations, but the deviations from this picture of quasi-coherent scattering happens if you take into account the relativistic corrections. Then the deviations started to appear from this simple picture, and this is the partial this is the redistribution of cyclotron lines. This is the most important effect. So in our work, we estimate different parameters, how the photons escape from the atmosphere if you take into account this kind of redistribution via the relativistic corrections to the resonance cross-section. So here, for example, the result of our numerical simulations. There you can see the relative fraction of photons emitted at some optical depths, depth tau, which will escape from the atmosphere. This is for the parameters. Then the temperature is 50 electron volts. I can stress it. I would like to stress this temperature. It's highly non-relativistic, but relativistic effects play a very important role because they allow photons to escape from the line center, which couldn't happen if you don't take into account these relativistic corrections. So here are some results of our analytical study. So the main parameter is the escape probability, which could be, in this case, which is proportional to 1 over optical depth. Not actually 1, but beta t. Beta t is the dimensionless thermal velocity in the plasma. So if you have just a diffusion escape from the atmosphere, then you have the probability 1 over t squared. So the redistribution is important if if you have to escape from the optical depths higher than t dot. And if this t dot is less than the thermalization depths there most of the photons are coming from, then the redistribution effects are important in the whole atmosphere. So this happens if your magnetic field is less than 10 to the minus 4 of the critical field for the temperatures of 50 electron volts. And if the magnetic field is less than that, then the coherent scattering are working. And the quantum recoil is important if the magnetic fields are larger than the 10 to the minus 2 of the critical field. So there are three zones. There are different kind of redistribution mechanism and different kind of escape of radiation are working in the atmospheres of neutron stars. For very small fields, the quasi-coherent approximations is working. For the middle magnetic fields from 10 to the minus 9 to 10 to the 12, for example, it depends for sure on temperature. The approximations, the partial frequency distribution is important. And if you are working in the high magnetic fields, then basically complete frequency distribution are working because the recoil is very large and it just strikes the photon out of the resonance via one scattering. So this, all these calculations could be applied to the radiation transfer problem, but you have, this is high dimensional, usually equations, and it's hard to solve them completely. You can use some approximations. It's very useful to derive some function, some approximate function which describes the distribution effects. So it was done by us recently, and some preliminary results with the modeling of radiation transfer in the atmosphere we obtained here. The test of our redistribution function, comparison of our approximate redistribution function with the exit one, so it kind of okay. Yes, and we used this redistribution function in order to obtain some spectra of escaping radiation for two different modes. But these results are quite preliminary, so it couldn't be used to fit some data up to the moment instead. So, and this is instead of conclusion, some summary of frequency redistribution effects that could happen in cyclotron lines in neutron stars' atmosphere. Yeah, my sketching skill leaves much to be desired, but nevertheless, you can work. If you have a small magnetic field, you will work in the coherent approximation, and the escape probability then 1 over t squared. Then if the magnetic field is higher, then the partial redistribution are important, and the escape probability is beta t over tau. And if the complete redistribution is working, this is then recoil is important, for example, then escape probability is 1 over tau. So that's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Questions? Again, no questions.
Well, just a note. If you want to consider this problem seriously and apply it to real situation, you at least should consider together the distribution not only over frequencies but also over angles and polarizations. Are there any polarizations in your equation at all?
For sure you should consider the polarization, but this is a separate work because this will work for any polarization if the scattering is happens.
But
and the problem, if you want to have real transfer equations to solve the real transfer equations taking into account the redistribution of the angles and other the frequencies, then you have to check that in these limits your redistribution function on the grid works as described by these analytical results, and no numerical, because it's very hard to constrain the redistribution function on the grid, which will hold that result, because most of the redistribution happens in the angles almost perpendicular to the magnetic field, and you have to have very fine grid on your in your radiation transfer equations near these frequencies and angles, and this is very hard work.
Of course, no doubt.
Yeah, so this is like a scheme what to expect in real radiation transfer simulations if you want to include these effects into account. Yeah, just because of this small angle problem, this is very hard to construct.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
More questions? Yes?
A small note that indeed in our paper with Rothschild we used we neglect logarithmic dependence in your formula, but basically we used partial redistribution in your terms function for escape probabilities, and it is only in this case which observations can be fitted. I mean, the change of the cyclotron line position with X-ray flux, which were obtained from observation. So, basically,
but logarithmic dependence is
logarithmic dependence is
very very weak.
Yes. So it's a confirmation from other side of your results.
Any more questions? If not, let's say Mikhail.